So welcome back everybody, or welcome to the parallel sessions. I will start today to talk about project activities we did in the GSOIL project, which was finished in May this year. But I also would like to share with you experiences we made with Inspire, how we influenced Inspire, and how we were influenced by Inspire in our project activities. And I would like to ask the question, are we entering now a new phase of data availability? And I will end with an appeal of streamlining existing data sharing platforms. So just for further introduction of myself, my name is Katharina Feiden. I'm working for the German Environmental Information Portal in Germany, and we took over the coordination of the GSOIL project. So this is a short project outline, just to introduce the project to you. GSOIL is an acronym for Assessment and Strategic Development of Inspire Compliant Geodata Services for European Soil Data. And we applied for that in 2008. And we didn't know during that time that we will run more or less in a parallel to the Inspire process. There are some positive sides about that, but also some negative sides, because we hoped that we could implement Inspire regulations already, but it was the other way around. We influenced also the data specification for soils. So as I said, we ended in May this year and had 3 years' time to work in a large consortium. We are 34 project partners coming from 18 European member states and involving 24 soil data providers. The other partners are more or less working in the IT sector, and we tried to combine our activities with the overall aim to establish an SDI for soil data for the participating partners. We tried to do this with our core activities. We started with a study of the frame conditions for improved soil data access in Europe, and there we checked the availability of data at our partners. And we have a quite diverse consortium coming from really different countries in Europe, and thus the availability of data is differently. The most participating countries, for example, from the Eastern countries, complained about that they more or less not have too many digital data available yet, but they were really keen to be informed about how to advance in the digital world. Then we put a focus on the development of an infrastructure for soil data exchange and components, meaning working with the data sets and the data providers, and to build up a technical infrastructure to share our data available. And this in means of standardized format of Inspire available information. We went even beyond Inspire while we worked on harmonization issues in the domain, and we provide guidance for harmonizing soil data under Inspire and even beyond. The focus of eContent Plus and the funding we received from the DG Information Society and Media was that they wanted to fund a best practice network, so meaning that the exchange of knowledge and the sharing of experiences was the main focus, but even though we managed to end our project with really a practical result. So let's see, we started with a content provision framework, meaning that we worked mainly with the domain experts from the soil area and had an analysis of the existing soil content framework and the existing inventories, which was also started already at the JRC in the soil domain, but we built up here on national and regional data sets for the involved data providers in the project. We, of course, analyzed the requirements coming from Inspire, but there I still need to remind that we are going on a parallel process with Inspire. And we ended this first package with a best practice guideline for developing a content framework for interoperable soil data in Europe, meaning we did some intellectual property rights assessment, some assessment on the regulations available, especially for the soil domain. Important are the regulations coming from the FAO, and also the existing work already done in other European consortia and also in at the JRC and at the European Commission. We went on then in the discussion of harmonizing metadata. So we developed a metadata profile for spatial soil data and data set series, provided them as reference material in the Inspire process, and then tested again the defined chapter that was provided by the Semantic Working Group on Soil, We had a lot of ongoing discussion there because Salt partners always wanted to have more content-related and quality-related elements in there, but we end up in a data specification where these components are slightly limited. Nevertheless, with the experience we had with our data providers, we set up a best practice guideline for creating and maintaining metadata. This was quite important as we saw that really handling metadata and creating them for data providers might be a crucial thing, even though you wouldn't expect it. Describing your own data is in some parts not as easy if you are setting requirements coming from the IT sector, because you need to find a common language on that. Since we are a European project and since it's an important matter in terms of discovery, we analyzed also multilingual aspects and needs for our metadata, and the Salt partners came up and said we need more than the existing GEMET. We would like to extend and to build up a Salt-specific thesaurus, a Salt test, which is a tool available now for the community, but which is, can only be a starting point in terms of technical infrastructure, and also with translations and discussing of terms. Finally, we provided our metadata via the GeoSol portal. But as I said, not without debating about the need for more content-related meta information for harmonization issues. Still, I can say and conclude that our data providers are not really satisfied with the metadata profile coming from Inspire. For them, it's too technical and not sufficient enough to find the data they need. But let's have a look back. At the beginning of GeoSol, there was hardly any metadata available at our data providers. They hardly set up services to find their data. There was a lack of knowledge about interoperability and all the technical components that we are dealing with under Inspire. And the content of soil map data has not yet been described in detail yet, which we should answer and answered also in GeoSol. So the package dealing with harmonization is the package that goes beyond Inspire, at least from the feeling from the data providers and also from the Commission's point of view. Since we had our review last week and they really appreciated our efforts taken in extending our Inspire-related tasks to the content-related harmonization. And the approach we did in GeoSol was based on four pillars. Reference terminology, harmonizing soil data profiles, harmonizing soil classification, and harmonizing soil maps. All this in the participating countries in, as you can see here, different scales, but mostly high resolution. So let's have a brief sip from the domain cases, test cases here. We had cases with single countries working with smaller data sets and maps available in their countries to harmonize. Adjoining areas of two countries, cross-border case studies, and also for Great Britain, a complete WRB cover for three partners. WRB is a classification coming from the UN and which is recommended under Inspire. I will really quickly going through these general threads and some sides of the test cases. All partners dealt with soil profiles and map legends and also with the translation to the classification. And some partners did geometric harmonization and compatibility of local soil profile classification system with FAO and guidelines for soil profile description. How does that look like? In case of single countries, yeah, you have the listed countries. They dealt with harmonization, different data sets within one country, as I stated. They evaluated methods for translation of local soil profile classifications to WRB. And the method for geometry quantifications. In case of adjoining areas of two or more partners, we have three cross-border test cases, as you can see here, it's listed here. They dealt with geometry comparison and with edge matching at borders. Short look on the results, as we see here, Austria and Slovakia cross-border. You can see here, in terms of fitting, that's fine, but we compare here different scales in high resolution, which was really a great outcome at the end when we harmonized these data sets. Also for France and Germany, we have the border running, here, it's the Rhine. We did immense work here, and also for Bulgaria, Romania, and Greece, with coming out here an example of a really high-resolution map coming from Greece, which was then implemented in a common approach. And as I said, for Great Britain, we managed only with three partners involved in the project to have a complete map about the translation of WRB. So geosoil harmonization at the end of the project lifetime. Great effort was also taken for the Inspire data specification version 2, which was reviewed, and there I can say that without a project like geosoil, data providers wouldn't participate in such a testing, because the knowledge would not be at a certain level to do so, and also for the cost-benefit decisions by partners, I might say that they wouldn't do that without having time, budget, and resources available to do so. We also did some testing with application schemas, which is also an ISO approach, and which is going back now as a cookbook to the certain ISO. The advantage for partners is that they can clearly identify the Inspire requirements, and that the knowledge itself about Inspire and all these technical needs in terms of data management were improved. So that means that the data itself may not be fit in the sense of best practice harmonization, but the data providers are now. They are ready now to deal further with the requirements coming out of Inspire and out of the needs for data management. So that was the content-related work we did. Then we worked also with the IT partners to set up a technical network. That was done as an integrated network and the central portal, the GeoSoil portal, where we had unique figures and semantic services as a thesaurus I already explained to you, gazetteers and classifications, but also a resource search mapping client, metadata harvesting, and so on. I will show you screenshots on that. And some distributed services in line with the Inspire recommendations as a metadata catalog, view service, download service, transformation service, and rights management service. Let's shortly have a look on that. This is the portal entry page, gsoil-portal.eu. And here the partners also dealt with the multilingual aspects, also with the handling of the portal, so they translated the interface. And you have a section about the project activities itself, our best practice guidelines that we establish in different work packages, our approach on data harmonization as a like a reading text information in the portal, but then coming to the interesting functionalities, searching for publications offered by partners, really quality limited to soil related publications, and also advanced search on the data available with here search results for soils, but only also via the gazetteer and the thesaurus, and a map client where it's possible to see WMS and also some download functions. For example, you can see also here our results coming from the harmonization studies, as here the view service with cross-border harmonized data for Slovakia and Austria. So what did IT partners then learn while working with data providers? That might be an interesting point. That a lot of effort was taken from the beginning to find a common terminology. When IT partners and domain experts are talking about use cases, they are for certain talking about different things. It took us more than a year to find a common language. The IT infrastructure is not always available at data provider side and might be set up from scratch. IT support is normally needed, but not always really included in the organizations. Minimum training for data providers is needed, and that should also be a point for discussion when we are discussing maintaining Inspire relevant services that we compiled. Not always even is it easy also for IT partners to work with the software packages available and to adapt it to the individual needs. And we learned that somehow, even though the advantages of working in such a project and with data and Inspire is existing at data providers, we need to push our data providers to work on that issue. Because they have, of course, more, from their point of view, more important things to discuss while meeting. So this was also an effort. So what did GSOL did for Inspire, how we were influenced by Inspire, I already said. This like really a system showing of our project. We developed best practices for metadata, but also applications, schema, and harmonizations. We developed an infrastructure, open tools and services available, the thesaurus, for example, and also some reference terminology we proved. And this is the output that goes to Inspire, the product catalogs that's available via the GSOL portal, and also the services. Can we expect a new phase of data availability coming out of these activities and working with Inspire? For GSOL partners, that means data availability under Inspire. You see different scales, high resolution scales that will be available from the 18 member states. And GSOL offers data from all kinds of scales and resolutions, and they are cataloged and described via metadata. They provide soil analytical data, which is mostly excluded. That was a wrong sentence, and I repeat, soil analytical data is mostly excluded. That's correct now. Especially smaller sized countries provide high resolution soil maps and applications, and the structure of the databases has similar complexity across scales, and harmonization faces the same difficulties and challenges in large scale as well as more generalized databases. This is our experience. I would like to take the last minutes to point out a specific situation that we are facing now while we ended our project. In the soil domain, there are existing different platforms for sharing available soil information. And from our experiences, while we planned our long-term operational plan, we were discussing how all these platforms can go together. And I would like to point out three things here, and these are the activities from the JRC, which the Soil Action Team is also partner in our advisory board. But even though we didn't manage to find a good cooperation to streamline our activities, to bring in the data that we work in our project, which was funded by the European Commission, which are new data, quality data, standardized data, and nearly Inspire-compliant data, to bring in into the activities of the JRC. And this is still an open issue. The JRC is running the European Soil Portal with this link. It's not really good to see here, but this is mainly a really excellent and good collected compilation of a content management system with data availability and documents and soil projects and so on, and which is highly appreciated by the soil community and the European Soil Bureau network. But still, in that sense, we need to say it's a content management system. They also offer, here further information, to point out the European Soil Data Center. We heard that also this morning from Guido Schmuck, that they are offering this also for data maps and applications. But not good to see here is that they are only offering that for services from the European Commission and only providing European data. So this is the situation here. They have two web presences for the European Soil Data Center. This is a screenshot we saw from Guido Schmuck, but I can tell you that the soil domain is more using the other one. Here they have, they host and point out to data, soil data relevant on European level. Important point here to note is they host it. Within GSOL, for example, or the approach from Inspire, it's about decentralized hosting. And they offer a wide metadata system, mainly from the European Soil Database. GSOIL portal, I already introduced to you. Here, the main quality issues that we provide here, data by regional and national partners, provided by domain experts for small-scale regional and national data, and Inspire relevant in terms of fitting of data, metadata, and best practice in harmonization. And I really need to point out, this is not about competition, this is about cooperation. And so my appeal at the end is that we need cooperation and streamlining in these sharing platforms when we are talking about data sharing, because this is just one example out of one specific domain where you have three different sharing platforms available, and it's about how all these can go together and combine all the good efforts that they took. And we hope that in the next 2 years, which is the plan of our long-term operational plan, we can increase our cooperation with the JRC. Because at the end, it's all about increasing soil data availability. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Catherine. For your presentation, it was very concise, precise, and efficient, and a lot of information, and you very well described the achievement and the challenges of your initiative. I will ask the floor if there are questions for Catherine, otherwise I will have also one question. Any question?
I can add maybe one point. Yes. Before you ask your question, that we have available a final brochure and a USB stick with all our results, because they are all public available. We share it with everybody, and we are happy to receive feedbacks. And if you raise your hand, our project partner from Bulgaria might give you one of those. And I hope you're interested. We don't want to take it home again. Okay, coming to your question.
Ray. Okay.
Now they're taking hands for the brochure.
Okay. Question. We've seen challenges and of your project, and I'm from the JRC. I forgot to introduce myself before, but I was in another domain on GMES coordination, so I'm completely new from this field, and I see that you mentioned the JRC.
Yes.
My question is for Inspire team. Overall, what needs to be done for you, or which is the message we can bring to the Inspire team for the future? If you have something to propose, something to suggest.
Yes, I forgot to mention that also in our advisory board, we had Robert Thomas, who is the contact point at the Inspire team of the JRC for the soil data specifications. He was involved from the beginning in our project, and we had all the time really ongoing discussions and feedback system directly linked. So the work with the Inspire team was really excellent. And we also had one expert out of our groups joining the thematic working group. And there also we had some feedback system on the open questions. I know that our group is discussing different things, as for example the thematic working group. But this is an example now really working with data providers and the IT sector.
Thank you. Thank you, Catherine. Any questions? Please.
Okay, maybe one. You mentioned that you set up a thesaurus for soil. Did you include there the definitions and compare them with what was defined by the Inspire data specifications or your own project or in the ISO specification? And or is it only to help the multilingual issues?
So I just understood now from the quality
The
half, but I think you asked something about including Inspire, ISO, and existing standards already.
Yes.
The thesaurus.
Yes, great.
Yes, that of course we did. We had a really strong interlinkage also with the other eContent Plus projects who worked on theme-specific thesauri, and also at the JRC there's a really active team working on terminologies and also thesauri. So we, from the technical side, we use the standards that are comparable so that all these things can go together with maybe a new project. In terms of terminology, we used, of course, the ISO and all the other existing terminologies.
Thank you. Thank you, Catherine. Thank you very much again.